Good morning, students. Okay, so today we're going to talk about your perineal care or perineal flushing. So, what are the equipments that we need? So, we have jar with cotton balls. Okay, this one. Jar with cotton balls and cleansing solution. Usually, it's a betadine solution. A pitcher with sterile warm water. So, yan. And then, kidney basin. This is used for soiled cotton balls. And then the bed pan, okay, that one. And then the forceps, pick up forceps, okay? So, yan. So, for the procedure ng ating perineal care or perineal flushing, of course, the first procedure is to wash our hands, okay? So, what is the rationale behind? This is to deter the spread of your microorganisms. Okay, number two, you have to screen the patient and explain the procedure, okay? So, di ba, kapag nasa ward kayo, so you have to screen the patient, ano paano yan, yung wala kasi tayong screen dito, so lagyan ng curtain, that is to provide privacy, and of course, explain the procedure to the patient so that the patient will cooperate. Okay, number three is to put the patient on bedpan. Okay, so, paano kayo mag-put ng patient on bedpan? Okay, pakita ko lang ha, expose ko lang muna siya kadali. Pero sa totoong buhay, hindi yan siya pwede ha. Okay, so paano kayo maglagay ng bedpan? Okay, the bedpan is positioned this way. Kasi ito yung papasok sa puwet niya. Ito yung hahawakan mo. Okay, so how do you position your patient on bedpan? You have to, kung meron kayong assistant, pwede niyong ipahawak ang mga legs. Or kung iba naman si patient, iangat ang puwet niya, you instruct the patient to, ma'am or sir, taas natin ang puwet ha, tapos may lalagay lang ako, bedpan. Okay. Okay, so ma'am, angat lang po ang puwet ha. Tapos i-support na lang din with your arm. Okay, and then, pasok, slide, yan. Okay? Okay, for your fourth procedure, you have to drape the patient, exposing only the part to be cleansed. So, ano kailangan natin i-expose? Diba, the perineal area lang. Okay, so yun lang i-expose natin, ha? Okay, so you have, paano mo i-position ang patient mo? You have to position the patient on the dorsal recumbent. So, if conscious ang patient, ma'am, sir, ganyan. So, ma'am, assist po natin, ma'am, ha? Taas lang po muna, angat lang po yung paa. And then, ilain mo na itong drape or yung blanket. Ganyan. So, exposing only the part to be exposed, ha? And then, yun. Tip nyo lang sa paa niya. So, kasi kailangan pa natin i-expose ang kanyang groin. So, ganyan. Para hindi naman mag-chill ang inyong patient. Kasi lalo na pag matanda ang inyong patient or naka-aircon kayo. Okay, so yan. Okay, so afterwards, you have to clean na the perineal area. So kung babae, you have to clean using 7 cotton balls. Okay, with cleansing solution. Okay, so using the pick-up forceps. So, ang ating principle lang naman is to clean the area from the cleanest up to the less cleaner area. So, ano ba pinakamarumi dito? Diba ito? Ang anus. So, before ka maginis ng anus, of course, you have to clean first itong mga labia majora, labia minora, and then before ka doon sa urethra and going down to the anus. Okay, so what is the first step? Okay, ano ang pinakauna natin linisin? Okay? The first is your labia majora doon sa far side mo. Okay, to prevent cross-contamination para hindi tayo ganyan ng ganyan. Okay, so you have to clean first the farthest area. Okay? So, you have to clean the labia majora first from your mons veneris or mons pubis. Okay, so yan. Isang stroke lang ha, isang stroke, pababa, go to the perineum, and then for your anus. And then after that, you discard. Okay, for your step 2, you have to get another cotton ball. And then clean the labia minora. Okay, labia minora, one stroke, never retrace the stroke ha, perineum, anus. Okay, then discard. Next, on your near side, okay? Ganun pa rin siya, mauna ang labia majora from your mons veneris or your mons pubis. Palabas. Ganyan. Anus, discard. And then, labia minora, okay, mons pubis. So, ganyan. ganyan, ganyan, and yan. And then inos, then discard. Okay, the fifth cotton ball will be used sa gitna. Okay? So, from your mons veneris or mons pubis, going down to your, ito, clit, to your urethra, vaginal orifice, going to your perineum, and then inus, and then discard. So, fifth cotton ball na yun, di ba? So, do we have to clean the groin? Of course. Okay, so for your sixth cotton ball, you have to use the sixth cotton ball on your far groin first. So, yan, ito, from taas pa rin, ay from taas, pababa ha, ang stroke. Like that, one stroke lang, then discard. Another, okay, so for your near side, one stroke lang for your groin, ganyan, pababa. Okay, so discard. So yan siya. Then after that, is to flush thoroughly with your sterile warm water. Okay, so di ba meron tayong sterile warm water? So meron ng bedpan, so para lang mabanlawan siya, ganyan. So, minsan kasi soap lang. Ayan. Ayan. So, from upper pa rin ha, taas, pababa. Para mabanlawan, ha? Ayan. Okay, so, once it's done, you have to dry the perineum, of course, diba? Using the cotton balls. Then, on the same stroke na ginawa nyo sa paglinis ng kanina. Okay, so, yung labia majora, labia minora, and then labia majora, labia minora. The same stroke lang din sa ginawa natin. Okay? And then, after that, yes to, pag na-dry na siya, so assuming na nag-dry na siya, you have to remove the bedpan and turn the patient to side if necessary. Okay? So, how do you remove your bedpan? Bubunutin lang ba? Agad? You know ha, you ask the patient, ma'am, angat ulit ang puwet. Okay, so, kung hindi niya kayang angat, you have the assistant. So, inangat niyo ang pet. Hindi niyo. Ayan. And then, after that, put perineal pad with an aftang motion if needed. So, yung mga perineal pads naman, usually yung mga napkins, diapers. Ayan. So, paano niyo magpapanyo yung ilagay? So, ganun lang naman diba? So, if meron kayong watcher or assistant, so you can do it with their assistant. Okay, so yun lang. Thank you. That is the perineal flushing ha. So, the next procedure is our perineal shaving. Okay, so what is the perineal shaving? It is the act of cutting or shaving the pubic and perineal hairs of the mother before delivery of the baby. Okay, so hindi naman pwede na manganak ang mother, di ba, na marami pang forest. Di ba, may forest pa. So, you have to clean. Obligation ng nurses na linisan before dalahin sa delivery room ang mother. Okay? What are the purposes? So, to cleanse the vulva, facilitate cutting, and repairing of your fistulotomy, of course, kasi pag tatahiin yan, mahihirap yan pag may buhok. And then, to curtail infection. So, what are the equipments that you need? Of course, you have the soap, warm water, underpad, and then your razor, or your sterile or disposable scissors, and examination gloves, and drape, of course. For your first procedure, you have to check the physician's order. Of course, you have to confirm the physician's order. So, hindi pwedeng mag-shape-shape lang na walang order ng doktor. Okay, next is to explain the procedure to the woman. Of course, this is to reduce anxiety and of course, to gain cooperation. Next is to explain to woman that she may experience itching as the hair grows back. So, di ba? Nakakararas. Yung mga nag-shape dyan. So, na-experience yun naman yan, di ba? So, you have to explain then na ganun talaga, normal talaga yun siya na ganap. Okay? So, this is to prepare the woman. Baka hindi siya magtaka na bakit after na na-shave nyo, kumati, ganyan. So, i-explain nyo talaga. And then, you have to put on your gloves. Okay? So, pwede na itong working gloves lang ha. Wala kasi kaming working gloves. So, this is to help prevent nosocomial infection and to implement universal precautions while handling body fluids. So, kasi hahawakan mo yung ang perineal area ng mother. So, alangan naman na wala kang gloves, wala kang barriers, wala kang protection. Okay? So, you have to wear gloves. Include na lang din natin dito, wala siya sa procedure na nakasulat. You have to place underpad on the patient's buttocks. Kasi, maglama-lama yung mga buhok. Okay? So, paano maglagay ng underpad? Okay? So, nasa bed making nyo yan, ha? Dati. Okay, so explain the procedure to the patient, of course. Okay, so yan. Sir, lagay tayo underpad, sir, ha? Or ma'am, ganyan. And then, paano kayo maglagay ng underpad? You have to position the patient na pa-side, di ba? Okay. So, always sa centerfold ha. Yung centerfold natin magkalimutan. Okay? Ganyan. And then, position ulit. Tapos another side naman. Kung kaya. Angat. 1, 2, 3, ma'am. So, ikaw lang isa. Pwede na na, no? As long as kaya mo ha, pero hindi na siya yung tipo na nabu-overreach ka. Pag hindi mo kaya, pag maliit ka, so transfer ka lang sa kanila, okay? Okay, so yan. Okay, so number... A next procedure is to cleanse the vulvar with soap solution or non-irrigating detergent. Preparation and admission after elimination, after vaginal examination, and for vaginal discharge. So, yung ginawa natin kanina na perineal flushing, so ganun ang gagawin. Okay, this is to maintain cleanliness, to curtail infection, and to promote comfort. Now, next procedure, if voided urine specimen that is indicated, obtain after cleansing the vulva. So, wag nyong ikolektahan ng... specimen or urine specimen before kayo mag-shave or before kayo mag-cleanse. Okay, so always do that after. Next is to proceed with the mini prep following hospital protocol. So, pwede kayo mag-clip. Pwede nyong gupitan lang or i-shave. Okay, between the vagina and anus. Especially the site used for your episiotomies. Okay? So, yan. So, how do you position your patient? Of course, i-expose nyo pa rin yung area that should be exposed only. Okay? So, use extreme care in shaving because even in expert hands, the razor leaves nicks and scrapes that serves as portals of entry for infection. Okay? So, paano ba ang way ng shaving, di ba? Nakita ninyo yung hair. Kung saan nagaturo yung hair, ganun din ang stroke ninyo. Huwag ninyong gawin opposite. So, if the hair, ang hair ng patient mo is pa-downward, di ba? Ang itsura ng patient mo, para pa ganyan ba? Padapa. So, ang way of your shaving, dapat mababa din. Okay, kung pa-side siya, kung nakikita nyo na yung hair niya papunta sa side, ganun din. So, huwag nyong i-opposite kasi masusugat at masusugat yan, okay? Okay, so to minimize danger of opening portals of infection and advertedly cutting small warts or moles. Okay, accomplish prep quickly between contraindications so to promote comfort and minimize danger of leaking. So, pag natapos na, pat the area with dry towel. Okay, pat the area with dry towel and then change to a dry underpad. Or pwede din yung mga gauze. Okay, if you have gauze, so pat mo yung area. So, ang motion niya from taas pa rin pababa, ha? Okay, so may gloves ka man. So, yan. Yan. So, pat the area. Yan. Taas, bababa. Okay, and then record the procedure. After that, is to record the procedure and any untoward observation. Okay, so now we're going to talk about your perineal douche. Okay, so douche yan siya ha. Okay, what is perineal douche? So, stream of water often containing medicinal or cleansing agents that is applied to a body part for hygienic or therapeutic purposes. So, may iba na spray, may iba na yung flushing of water. Okay, now the equipments used is the same as your equipment with your flushing. So, we have the jar with cotton balls. Cleansing betadine solution ng cotton balls, pitcher with warm sterile water, kidney basin,
bedpan, screen for your to provide privacy, and then the forceps. Okay? Forceps, or kung naka-gloves kayo, you can, ano. Now, we have to clean the female perineal, douche. Okay, so we proceed with, of course, number one is to assess the need for external douche, and then prepare the equipment and adjust bed to comfortable working height. So, di ba, meron naman yan sa inyong bed making dati, so paano kayo mag-adjust? So, kung merong mga tapakan, on your part then, para hindi kayo ma-strain, okay, to provide comfort and safe time. Now, bring the pieces of equipment to the bedside. Then, identify the patient, introduce yourself, and explain the procedure. Of course, you have to identify the patient kasi baka hindi siya yung patient na ma-douche ninyo, di ba? Iba pala, o lalo na sa ward. So, iba-iba. So, how do you identify your patient? You ask the patient's name, okay? And then, you introduce yourself. So, di ba, tinuruan na kayo niyan dati? And, to explain the procedure, this is to have full participation from the patient for the procedure. Of course, especially, private area ang ating ginagalaw. Okay, that provides privacy to the patient and the places on supine position. So, ginawa na namin ganito ha, kasi ano na lang namin ito. Then, next is you have to change the top sheet with wet bath blanket or your blanket. So, ginawa naman natin yan sa bed making. So, hindi na natin ulitin ha. And then, place as bed protector. Okay, drapes patient with bath blanket. And then, places the patient on bedpan in dorsal recumbent position. So, ito na. Ito na siya. So, the bedpan will collect the water used during the perineal cleaning. Okay, next slide tayo. Okay, so, test the temperature of your water. So, di ba, halimbawa ito. So, paano ka mag-test? So, pwede mong ipa-assist sa patient or ipa-test the patient. Kung okay na. O kung unconscious siya, okay, you can use your diba, your elbow to check the temperature. Or ito, itong kamay. Ganyan. So, check mo yung temperature na hindi masyadong mainit, hindi masyadong malamig. And then, you have to wear your gloves. Okay, working gloves will do. Well, expose na. Okay, so what where is your far side ganit? Kung dito ako, doon. Okay, so just expose. And then, wash mo lang siya. So, throw-in. Yan, pataas na yan, pababa. Okay, so ganun naman ulit. Okay, so hanggang sa mabasa siya. And then by the use of your CB, soap in soap solution, use a zigzag motion down. Okay, so ang first is you're from your mons pubis going up. Okay, so ito. Using zigzag motion. Okay, so we have the betadine cleansing solution. So, kung ito yung men's pubis niya, paakyat ha na zigzag motion. So, ito. Starting from here, taas. Okay, using one stroke. And then, discard. Next. So, thorough cleansing and care should be taken to avoid introducing secretions and bacteria into the opening through which the urine is released. So, contamination of this area can lead to urinary tract infection. Okay, next, applies another cotton ball on the far groin. Okay? Okay, so, sana far groin ito, di ba? Okay, so, paano ang stroking natin for far groin? So, ito ang groin niya. So, pa. So, ganyan. Pasigzag pa rin siya pataas. So, hanggang sa ano, ganyan. So, isa lang siya ha, isang ano lang, isang stroke. So, ulitin ko ha. Pero, ano ha, same ano, yan. Pat baba. Using zigzag motion, yan. Paakyat. Okay? And then, you throw. Discard. Next. Use the same stroke on the near groin din. Sa'yo. Lapit. Okay? Using the same stroke. Okay, so, yan. Pasigzag. Hanggang sa may high. Okay? Then, discard. So, next is to separate the labia and apply another CB on each labia. So, starting from the far side using the gentle stroke. Okay, so ito. Another cotton ball. So, i-retract mo konti yung vagina niya para mag-open. Okay, so, from your labia majora. So, pwede ito, labia minora. Okay? Discard. So, napansin ninyo, ang ginawa ko, isang cotton ball lang, pero hindi siya same side. Okay, so isang cotton ball sa labia majora,
Tapos, another side naman ng cotton ball mo for your labia, minor. Okay, and then discard.
You do that on the same, on your near side.
Okay, so, labia majora, and then labia minora. Okay, so, make sure lang din, pero you can use another cotton ball kung marami kayo. Okay? So, ganyan. And then discard. And after that, apply another CV using a downward stroke from urethra going to the vaginal orifice. So, saan yung vaginal orifice niya? So, here. At pababa. Okay. This is the clit, diba? Dito yung ating urinary meatus. Okay. So, pababa hanggang sa may vaginal orifice. Okay. So, ito. Tapos, discard. And then, use another cotton ball from urethra going to the anus na. Okay, so this one, from here, going down to the vaginal orifice, to the perineum, and then to the anus, and then discard, okay? Rinse the perineal area using the warm water. Okay, so starting from your far side, okay? So, buhos tayo ng tubig dito. So, hindi na tayo magbuhos ha, kaya ano. Okay, so buhos tayo from the far side. So, hanggang sa mabanlawan siya, okay? Hanggang dito. Oh, so, na-rinse na siya ha. So, for example, this one. Ano ko lang, itanggal ko lang yung mga nakita niyo. So, next is to tap or dry the area. Okay, so first is from far area pa din or sa taas. So, pag sa leg, start ka dito. Okay, pat mo yung area. Bababa ha. Tapos, at puntang growing. Ganyan. So, discard. After that, you're near growing ulit. So, you have to tap. Tapos, to the grow it and then discard. Now, for your, for the area talaga. So, from taas, pababa. So, going down. Okay, so yan. So, makagamit kayo ng, ng kahit ilan pa. For as long as na-dry na. Okay, dahil basta ang motion nyo lang is pataas, pababa. Okay, discard and then. Okay. So, after that, ayan na, na-discard na. So, nag-dry na siya. Now, remove the bedpan and turn the patient aside. So, dry the buttocks with toilet paper or your clean towel. Okay, so, para i-remove. Okay, ma'am, tanggalin po natin, ma'am. Angat po ang puwet. Okay. So, ganyan. Okay, and then, you ask the patient to turn to side kasi papunasan mo yung puwet niya. Okay, kasi basa din yan siya. So, yun. So, alam nyo naman kung paano mag-turn to side na patient, no? Tapos yun, punasan nyo lang yung puwet niya, maharap nyo doon, okay? And then, apply lotion if needed. So, kung meron lang. And then, replaces blanket with top sheet and makes the patient comfortable. Okay, so, before ka nyan, so, di ba, pag naano, before ka maglagay ng top sheet, syempre, lagyan mo muna ng underpa, or lagyan mo muna siya ng mga napkin, or kung diaper ko ano man. So, para ano, comfortable din siya. Hindi siya nakaupo. Okay, then, examine the content of the bedpan and close it in the toilet bowl. So, i-examine mo. Kung madubo ba, ano ba napansin nyo doon sa kanyang secretions. Okay? For your male, okay, so, ito lang. So, ganito na lang ha. Pakita ko na lang ganito. So, same procedure siya as step 1 to 11. As of your perineal douche, paano siya i-prepare. Now, in cleansing this one, okay, so, okay, with your non-dominant hand, firmly holds the penis in an upright position. So, since I am a right-handed person, my non-dominant hand is your ang left ko. So, anong gagawin ko? Paano maghawak? Ganito ha. Huwag ganyan. Huwag ganito. So, full. Okay? So, full grip. So, hindi ganyan ha. Hindi ganyan. So, ganito siya para ma-assist ninyo. Maayos. Okay? Firmly holds the penis. Okay? In an upright position. So, using one CV daw, soap in betadine solution washes the urethral meatus. So, saan ba ang meatus? So, dito, di ba? In a circular motion. Okay? Then, discard. Next, applies a second CV using circular motion on the glans penis. Okay, where is your glans penis? Okay, so, starting from here, paikot, 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 hanggang sa tapos ng ano. Let's finish natin, okay? Okay, so one stroke lang yan. Then after that, uses the third CB and fourth CB to wash the sides of the shaft. So, paano ang shaft T and paano maglinis sa shaft, okay? Diba naka-hold ka firmly? So, third and fourth cotton ball down. So, pwede siya dito. One stroke, pababa. Okay, then yung hindi mo ginamit na side, pwede dito. Yan. Tapos, another na naman kung ano, ganyan. Ha? So, hanggang sa maano niyo yung side. Ganyan, pababa. Basta pababa lang ang stroke. Pag naubos na lahat ng ano, discard ng lahat ng side and then get another one. Okay, then you use naman sa paglinis. Yan. So, one. Ayan na naman. Hanggang sa malinis niyo yung lahat ng ano niya, ng sides. Okay? Okay, so, kung marami kayong cotton balls, hanggang sa malinisan niyo siya. Okay? So, wag lang balik-balik ang straw. Okay? So, malinisan na natin ang shaft. Then, uses the deep CB or another CB to wash the far side of the mons. Pubis going downward to the groin. Okay, then, so from here, basa na yung mons pubis niya, ganyan. Kung dito ba yan, papunta, palabas sa may singit banda. Pababa lang din. Okay. Okay? And then, you do the same on the other side. Okay, so here, from here, yan, groin niya, ganyan, pababa. Okay. So, after that, using your CB, another CB, you cleanse the scrotum. Okay, going towards the anus. So, kung ito, diba, nag-grip mo ito siya. So, yan, pwede mo yan. Yan, so, yan, para ma zigzag motion, sorry. Wait lang. Okay, so, ganyan siya ha, ganyan. Zigzag motion hanggang sa ano, pababa, hanggang sa may anus. Okay? And then, another CB from here. Okay, using zigzag motion naman. Pababa hanggang sa may anus and then discard. Okay, and then bring the equipment. So after that, alam naman hayaan natin na hindi siya nabandawan. So ganun pa rin siya. So bandawan mo pa rin siya from your ano, far side. Ganyan, pababa ha, pababa. So let the ano, let the gravity of the water na pababa. Flow downwards, okay? And then, pag na-rinse mo na siya, okay, i-dry mo pa rin siya ng toilet paper or your toilet toilet paper. Okay, so, di mo manabasa yung leg niya, no? So, pwede ka mag-start here. So, paikot. Ganyan. So, firmly grasp mo pa rin yan siya. Ganyan. Tapos, discard. So, yan. Hanggang sa mapalibutan, maano nyo siya. And then, yan. Tapos, from here to the scrotum. Ganyan. Downward. Tapos, another na naman. So, hanggang sa mag-dry lang siya. Okay? Next is to bring the equipment back to the utility room and that's the aftercare. So, lahat ng mga nagamit, aftercare. So, controlling the spread of pathogens in a primary principle of asepsis. So, remove gloves and wash your hands. Okay? And then, document the performance of the procedure, the objective and subjective findings, and the patient's response. So, written information documents the individualized care of the patient. So, you have to document whatever is performed. Or, di ba? So, say for example, meron tayong perineal care provided. So, moderate amount of lochia rubra noted at perineal pad. So, episiotomy and perineal swollen. Bean size external hemorrhoids noted. Verbalized feeling of comfort after the procedure. Okay? So, ganyan siya. Yan ang ating perineal douche. Okay, so thank you.